Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome, man. Welcome to Beyond Classic Rock. Today, got a complimentary quad coming your way, man. And it's featuring the music of three different artists. R.E.M., The Killers, and Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. So, first starting with R.E.M., we're hitting up Texarkana, followed by R.E.M. again, Country Feedback. Then The Killers doing Bling, Confessions of a King. And finally, Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, and they're doing The Death of You and Me. So man, before I pop this off, I just want to give a shout out and a thanks very much to April Garris. April, thanks very much, man. Thanks for the recommendations and providing the links. It's really cool. Of course, I've heard of REM. The Killers, I would have to hear their music first for it to click in. I'm not sure. Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds, same thing. You know, so great thing about this platform, man. You know, we are going in so many different directions and getting introduced to things that is not in our everyday and that we've not been exposed to. So I really dig that for this platform, man. So with that said, let's check out REM, and this is Texarkana. Let's get it. Texarkana is being described as that perfect oasis. It's funny, it's not even mentioned in the song, though. So, Texarkana by R.A.M. The first question I have for you right off the top is this. With R.E.M., because I'm thinking of a different voice. So I'm guessing that they take turns singing the lead, because I'm thinking of Orange Crush, and I'm thinking of, is it Drive? And it's a deeper voice. It's someone with a deeper voice than what I'm hearing here. So I'm guessing it's a different person and they take turns singing. I don't know much about R.E.M. I know that they are huge, massively successful, and they came up in a time when videos were really, really at their peak, and that kind of a new sound was all around, and they were one of the big shooting stars. I know that much. I know their music to hear their music, but I don't know a tremendous amount about them. I've only done one R.E.M. reaction, and it included Drive and it included Orange Crush, and we're going back, so forgive me, I can't remember who it was that sent me that recommendation. And I can't remember what the other songs were in that reaction, if it was just a two, or more than likely it was a quad. Yeah, I'm going to have to go back in time. But yeah, this was not in the lineup of those songs in that reaction anyway. So, great band, very, very, very legendary band, very successful band, and good song. It has shades of familiarity to me. I'm sure that I've heard it before, I just don't have a connecting memory. That's the big thing for me. When I hear music from the past or whatever, usually more than 50% of the time, I would say, I have some sort of a connecting memory, a visual in my head, and sometimes I don't. In this case, it sounds familiar, but I don't have any kind of a visual or a memory in my head. But that's all good, man. It can't be that way with every damn song. So, let's first check out the guys, R.E.M., and then we'll hit up the song information, man. So, R.E.M. R.E.M. Was an American rock band from Athens, Georgia, formed in 1980 by drummer Bill Berry, guitarist Peter Buck, bassist Mike Mills, and lead vocalist Michael Stipe, who were students at the University of Georgia. Liner notes from some of the band's albums list attorney Burtis Downs and manager Jefferson Holt as non-musical members. One of the first alternative rock bands, R.E.M. was noted for Buck's ringing, arpeggiated guitar style, Stipe's distinctive vocal quality, unique stage presence, and obscure lyrics, Mills' melodic bass lines and backing vocals, and Berry's tight, economical drumming style. In the early 90s, other alternative rock acts such as Nirvana and Pavement viewed R.E.M. as a pioneer of the genre. After Berry left the band in 1997, the band continued its career in the 2000s with mixed critical and commercial success. The band broke up amicably in 2011, with members devoting time to solo projects after having sold more than 85 million albums worldwide and becoming one of the world's best-selling music acts. Wow. And it's great that they broke up amicably, so we could possibly see them coming back together again. Maybe, we'll see. So, Texarkana. Texarkana is a song from R.E.M.'s studio album Out of Time. Though not released as an official single, it managed to chart at number 4 on the Modern Rock Tracks chart and number 6 on the Mainstream Rock Tracks chart. This song was written musically and lyrically by bassist Mike Mills, credited to Berry, Buck, Mills, and Stipe, as vocalist Michael Stipe had been having problems for weeks trying to come up with lyrics for it. As a result, Mills also sang lead vocals. Okay, yeah, see, I was right. Yeah, okay. So, Stipe is the voice that I'm used to hearing. And this voice, Michael Mills, his voice is a little bit more lighter. Okay, I was right. Yeah, I wasn't out of my mind. The title is a reference to the city of Texarkana, located on the border of Texas and Arkansas, originally mentioned in the chorus before it was changed. Okay, why would they change it then? Why would they change that? Because a lot of people would be saying the same thing as me, probably. Hey, you know, the song is titled Texarkana, but it's not even in the song. So why would they have changed it? Let me know if you know. I gotta look into that further. As heard on the outtakes of Time Bootleg, as well as Out of Time's 25th anniversary edition, Stipes' original chorus was, quote, "When I'm out in Texarkana, where's that county line? Another county line." Okay, so that was the verse. All right, interesting. Album info. Out of Time has sold more than 4.5 million copies in the US and more than 18 million copies worldwide. The album won 3 Grammy Awards in 92, one as Best Alternative Music Album, and 2 for the first single, Losing My Religion. Great song. Yeah, now that I think about it, I think Losing My Religion was also in that initial REM reaction that I did. The person who recommended this to me, forgive me for not remembering, don't kick my ass. That happens a lot, especially if it's a patron's, because patrons have a direct message link to me. They'll send me these messages, man. Oh, man. When I screw up, they let me know. All right, so let's hit up our second track, man, and that being Country Feedback. So, REM, Country Feedback. Let's get it. On the downside.
It's crazy what you could have had. It's crazy what you could have had. I need this.
It's freedom.
It's crazy what you could have had. Crazy what you could have had. I need this. It's crazy what you could have. I need this.
freedom from the relationship. It's now either toxic or just dead. Bringing them down. Feedback. Yeah. I think he's describing a relationship and how the relationship has died, or he needs freedom from it because it's toxic, perhaps. And, you know, they've tried a whole bunch of different things. And you mentioned wanted ads. Maybe they even tried to have a, I don't know, open relationship. See other people. When a couple is in that desperate state of trying to hang on, they will do almost anything, any kind of compromise in order to stay together. You know what I'm saying? So I think he's describing that there. I don't think he mentioned kids in the confines of this all, but you can assume that kids are maybe even a part of it too, and they're staying together for the kids. They're trying hard to stay together. Yeah, that's the feeling I'm getting. That's the visual I got from this. All right, man. So, country feedback. Yes, and that's the voice that I'm used to hearing. He's got a really, really great, he's got great hang time in his delivery. And what I mean by that is that he seems to have a really, really good way to either be upbeat or to be lamenting, you know, and he can drag that out a little bit. Not as good as Tom York from Radiohead, you know. Tom's lament is just choice, but Stipe, that's his name. He's really, really good with that as well. All right, Country Feedback. Country Feedback is a song by R.E.M. from their 1991 album, Out of Time. The title describes the music, country rock influence with feedback and pedaled steel guitar. Okay. I was wondering again, you know, because I don't recall country feedback being in the actual title of the song. Rather than describing the song's lyrical content, a series of chaotic, disconnected, and keening observations describing the state of mind of a protagonist contemplating the breakdown of a relationship. That's what I said, but not in such incredible verbiage here, man. I tell you, being a critic, you gotta have some complex vocab. Michael Stipe has claimed that he did not even write the whole lyric down, that he just had a piece of paper with a few words. I sang it and I walked out. The following day, the hastily improvised take was deemed good enough and it was not re-recorded. Peter Buck has gone even further to say that it's exactly what was on his mind that day. It was real. Stipe has said at one concert that it's his favorite R.E.M. song. All right. The song is featured on the Perfect Square DVD from 2003 and opens with lyrics from Chorus and the Ring, followed by Stipe's own editions of Instinct, Gut Feelings, Feelings. This performance was also added to the two-disc special edition version of the band's 2003 Greatest Hits CD. In time, although the original 1990 recording was left off the main disc. The studio recording also appears on the 2011 career-spanning compilation Part Lies, Part Heart, Part Truth, Part Garbage from 82 to 2011. In addition, live versions have appeared on a fan club Fan Club single and the singles for Bang and Blame and At My Most Beautiful. R.E.M. have performed the song as part of the Bridge School Benefit Concert Series, with Neil Young providing additional guitar. Okay. Yeah, so this song definitely has had a spotlight, you know, being of social significance. Good song. And one of his favorite R.E.M. songs. So, that's a look at R.E.M., man. Let's check out The Killers. And this is Bling, Confessions of a King. The Killers, Bling, Confessions of a King. Let's get it.
It's not so bad, it's not so bad. How do you know that you're right? I awoke on the roadside, in the land of the free ride. I can't pull it any longer, the sun is
singer, isn't it?
So you sling rocks at the riptide.
Strong and clear.
Am I wrong or am I right? I hit the bottom with a hook, quite strange. I get my glory in the desert rain. Watch it go. Say it's hard enough to live.
Okay. So that's the Killers. Sorry, man. I don't feel that I've ever heard of them. And in listening to their sound, I don't think I've ever heard any of their music before, man. Good sounding band, though. Damn, the lead singer has a great, great singing voice, man. Sounds like a young Bono, doesn't he? And very expressive in his own right, too. He's a mixture of a couple of different singers I can think of. But yeah, really good singer, good projection, nice and clear, can understand every single thing that he's saying. He really leans into some of the areas that you need to focus on so that he can convey to you the passion of his angst, his anguish, his desperation, whatever the case is. For a minute there, I thought he was having a conversation with God about, you know, being brave enough to, I don't know, face the world and get on with life. But I think it's he is talking to himself, you know, trying to kind of get him, kick himself in the butt and to get up and get moving and, you know, take the world and take what's mine and go for it and all of that sort of thing. So it's I think it's like one of those everyday cycles of, you know, facing life and facing the world and having to get up out of bed and go into the world and make your way and the ins and outs, the back and forth and all of that. Sometimes that grind alone is really, really hard and trying for a lot of people, you know? And so I've known people like that who basically just drag their asses around from day to day. And they're just, I don't know, waiting for a bus to hit them, take them out of their misery, right? Because they're just on a hamster wheel, just going through the motions. That's the visual that I'm getting from this song. I could be completely off, man. Yeah, good band, good sounding band, good musicianship, really excellent singer. The singer is definitely, and of course, what they're trying to convey and the message of the song and the visuals that I'm getting, excellent. All right, so let's check these dudes out, man. The Killers. The Killers are an American rock band formed in LA in 2001 by Brandon Flowers, lead vocals, keyboards, and bass, and Dave Kooning, lead guitar backing vocals. The band went through a number of early lineup changes, but by 2002, they had settled on a lineup of Flowers, Kooning, Mark Stormer, bass guitar, rhythm guitar backing vocals, and Ronnie Vannucci Jr., drums and percussion. The band's name is derived from a logo on the bass drum of a fictitious band portrayed in the music video for the New Order song, Crystal. The band has released 6 consecutive chart-topping studio albums. The Killers are considered one of the biggest rock bands of the 21st century and the most successful act to ever emerge from Nevada, selling more than 28 million records worldwide, including 10.8 million in the US alone. They've performed in over 50 countries and on 6 continents, headlining venues such as Madison Square Garden, Wembley Stadium, and Glastonbury Festival in 2007 and in 2019. Holy cow, man. It's great accomplishments, and it's sad I've never heard of these guys. Criminal. Bling, Confessions of a King, appears on Sam's Town. It's the second studio album by American rock band The Killers. It was released September 27, 2006 by Island Records. Bling tells the victorious story of how frontman Brandon Flowers' father recanted alcoholism and Catholicism to become a Mormon when Brandon was 5. Flowers told NME, quote, "I guess it's like a medal for my father. It's glorifying the person who does a great job raising his kids, just going to work every day." A lot of people in bands write about the working stiffs. I wanted to make something that was the opposite because that's what my family is and I'm proud of it. My dad is 64 years old. He raised 6 kids and now he's got 20 grandkids. And I guess that's what the ending of the song is about. When you see him playing with his grandkids, he's a happy man. Unquote. Yeah, okay. So I was partially right about this song and the grind of life and your responsibilities and your triumphs and all of that sort of thing and overcoming the everyday. And this is what his dad has done in the form of living to such a ripe old age, raising kids, and now he's rewarded with 20 grandkids and he's still around to actually enjoy his grandkids. That's a great accomplishment, man. Obviously, his dad's his hero. Regarding the album, frontman Brandon Flowers noted that he wanted to create an album that captured chronologically everything important that got me to where I am today. Sam's Town has sold almost 5 million copies worldwide. On October 7, 2016, Sam's Town was reissued as a remastered double vinyl by Bong Load Records, celebrating the 10th anniversary of the album. The reissue is limited to 5,000 copies and included two bonus tracks, the previously unreleased demo, Peace of Mind, and a Pet Shop Boys remix of Read My Mind. In later years, the album gained a cult following and has been critically lauded as a classic and one of the best rock albums of the 2000s. Despite its two-year rating by Rolling Stone, Sam's Town was voted by the magazine readers in December of 2009 as the most underrated album of the decade. Q Magazine ranked it as the 11th best album of the 21st century. Damn, man. Again, some really, really high praise for these guys that I've never heard of. Unbelievable. See, it's part of the reasons why I do reactions, man. Expanding my horizons. All right, let's hit up our final track, man. Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. And the song is The Death of You and Me. The Death of You and Me. Let's get it. Video, man. Nice. Let's see what they look like. I recognize that older lady. She's an actress. I think she's a British actress. Yeah. take this job and shut it. There she is again. That lady. I gotta know who that is. Out of there. A little hesitation. To be continued. Nice. Yeah, obviously the song has to do with the game, changes, and moving on. And I think it's a relationship again where I think the guy sitting with the guitar and playing, he's, you know, one half of the relationship, and the waitress is another half, and she wants something else. She wants to move on, and she's looking for an opportunity to get the hell out of Dodge, and she's found it. Do you guys know who that person is? The older lady sitting down and just kind of looking around. I recognize her. I think she's a British actress. I'm pretty sure, man. Because I there was a time when I used to watch a lot of British TV shows. I find that they're the way they develop their drama and they drag out and tell a story is really, really interesting. Yeah, I used to watch Doc Martin and the Midsummer Mysteries and all of these different kinds of really cool British TV shows. The Midsummer Murders. The Midsummer Murders, it's like 20 seasons. And throughout all of those seasons, we've come to know quite a number of really great British actors. You know, a whole host of them from the Game of Thrones, Henry Cavill, all of these really, really great, notable British actors that you see prominent these days. They've all come from the smaller productions of British TV. Midsummer Murders is a really good example of what I'm talking about. That lady actress in there, I'm pretty sure she is a British actress, and I just can't remember her name. If you guys know who that lady is, please let me know. I really like her, even though I can't put a name to her. All right. Now, good song. Excellent song, really, really good sound. Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. Excellent. And The Death of You and Me is the song. Don't need to explain that any further, especially with the video confirming exactly what it's all about. Yeah, good sounding band, really excellent singer. And again, good clarity, good delivery. He's got a really, really nice bluesy signature and delivery to him. I really like that. Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. Yeah, and again, another band that I hadn't heard of. And with such a good sound, such a good sounding song, yeah, it's criminal. So, Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds are an English rock band formed in 2009 as the sole moniker of former Oasis songwriter, lead guitarist, and backing vocalist Noel Gallagher. Okay. And they're an English band, so if they shot this in Europe, I can understand, okay, the British actress. Since his departure from Oasis in August 2009, many speculated that Gallagher might record a solo album. In July 2011, he held a press conference to confirm this. Later that year, Noel released the project's self-titled debut album. Several singles from the album were released, including The Death of You and Me, If I Had a Gun, aka What a Life, Dream On, and Everybody's on the Run. Gallagher stated in an interview on the Jonathan Ross Show that the inspiration for the band's name was from two sources, The idea to prefix the name with Noel Gallagher's was formed while he was listening to the album Peter Green's Fleetwood Mac, while the latter part of the name is taken from the song High Flying Bird, most notably recorded by Jefferson Airplane. Shout out to Peter Green. I miss you, man. My dad misses you a whole ton. Holy shit, when Peter Green died, my dad didn't talk for like a couple of days. The Death of You and Me. The Death of You and Me is the debut single by English rock band Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. The song was written by Noel Gallagher as his first solo effort and produced by Gallagher and Dave Sardy. It was released on the 21st of August 2011 by Sour Mash Records as the debut single and lead single from the band's eponymous debut album. On the 28th of August 2011, the song debuted at number 15 on the UK singles chart. Background. Rumors that The Death of You and Me was the name of Gallagher's first solo single began to surface in June 2011. It was confirmed the following month that the song was to be released as the musician's first solo single on the 21st of August, though Gallagher's own label, Sour Mash Records, with B-side, The Good... Through Gallagher's own label, Sour Mash Records, with B-side, The Good Rebel. When asked at a press conference whether the meaning of the song was related to the relationship between himself and former bandmate and brother Liam Gallagher replied that it was based on the saying, "If we don't leave this place, it'll be the death of you and me," and that it was a bit more romantic than that, his relationship with his brother. And it's a romantic song about people escaping the surroundings they're in and having a jolly good time and living happily ever after. So no, it wasn't about his relationship with his brother. It's I guess it has to do with a fictional relationship. Yeah, as depicted in the video. Music video. Filmed in LA, the music video for The Death of You and Me starts at a cafe and a waitress serving customers, including Gallagher, before taking a break. She then goes outside and prepares to dive backwards into a swimming pool, but is pushed in by Gallagher. She then goes out of the pool and walks through the cafe and out the front to see a band and a horse-drawn wagon, which appeared through the video, stopping outside the cafe. The wagon's door then opens and the waitress goes inside before the door slams shut. The video ends with the words "to be continued." The story then continues in the second single from the album, aka What a Life. Okay. The video was made available to viewers in the UK on the 25th of July 2011. It also shows that Noel Gallagher is left-handed despite playing the guitar right-handed. Okay. The waitress is played by actress Devon Ogden, directed and produced by Mike Bruce, with producers Blake West and Camille LeBry of United Film House. I'm after the name of the older actress that was sitting at the table. If you guys know, let me know. All right, hey man, excellent, excellent song. And this guy was from Oasis. The voice had a familiar ring to it, and I couldn't place his name. So it didn't connect with me until I realized, okay, they're from Oasis. Good quad, April. Overall, all of these songs are very, very well paired. REM, The Killers, and Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds. Really, really good pairing of songs here, man. And a cool video too. Really cool video. All right. So that concludes my look at these. Great acts, man. And I'm just, let me just check my notes before I bounce real quick. Yeah, so I got reactions I gotta get to. I'm starting to fall behind by a few days. Rob, RHCP, Joshua, Marco, I gotta hit those reactions up and it'll be done before the weekend is through. Where are we at now? We're at Thursday. So yeah, I'll get right on those, man. So yeah, back to April. Thanks very much. I appreciate you introducing me to two new acts. And I really like this whole quad overall. And another really, really good sounding song, Texarkana from REM, with a different voice. So that was really interesting as well. Overall, very, very good quad. So thanks very much. I appreciate it. I hope everybody liked this. Send me some recommendations for REM. I'll definitely take the time, man. These guys are fantastic. Overall, they're all great, man. So thanks again, April. Have a good one, everybody. Take care. I'll see you in another reaction. Peace.